హలో స్టూడెంట్స్, వెల్కమ్ టు ట్యూటిట్యూడ్. ఐఎమ్ భార్గవ్ అండ్ ఐ హ్యావ్ ద టీచింగ్ ఎక్స్పీరియన్స్ ఆఫ్ మోర్ దెన్ 10 ఇయర్స్ ఫర్ ఈసీ పీపుల్ అండ్ ఐఎమ్ గోయింగ్ టు ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్ అబౌట్ హౌ టు ప్రిపేర్ ద గేట్ ఎగ్జామినేషన్ ఫర్ గేట్ 2023. ఇన్ కేస్ ఆఫ్ ది ఈసీఈ, ద గేట్ సిలబస్ ఈజ్ ఫర్ 10 సబ్జెక్ట్స్ ఈజ్ దేర్ అండ్ అవుట్ ఆఫ్ 10 సబ్జెక్ట్స్ వీ కెన్ ఏబుల్ టు డివైడ్ ఇన్ టు 3 గ్రూప్స్. ఫస్ట్ గ్రూప్ ఈజ్ ఇన్వాల్వింగ్ ద జనరల్ ఆప్టిట్యూడ్ అండ్ మ్యాథమెటిక్స్ అండ్ సెకండ్ గ్రూప్ ఈజ్ ఇన్వాల్వింగ్ some basic subjects. The third group is involving the core subjects. In case of group 1, we have general aptitude and mathematics. So these we can able to see from our childhood onwards. So mathematics involves the linear algebra, calculus, differential equations, probability, like these some subjects are there. So these subjects are mandatory for understanding the core subjects. So for example, in case of the EMTL, we need to apply the vector calculus. Without vector calculus, we cannot able to learn the electromagnetic fields and transmission lines. And in case of this general aptitude, very basics are there. Everyone can able to understand the general aptitude and more amount of marks are allocated for the general aptitude and mathematics. Nearly 28 to 30 marks are allocated for the general aptitude and mathematics. Purely 15 marks are given for the general aptitude only. And 13 to 15 marks are allocated for the mathematics, so that without having any knowledge on the core subjects also, we can able to qualify. For qualification purpose only, I am telling, this is about mathematics and general aptitude. When you come to this electronic subjects, like I have told about the group 2 subjects. In the group 2 subjects, we can able to include 5 subjects. Those are network theory, signals and systems, control systems, EDC and digital circuits. And out of all these 5 subjects, network theory, signals and systems are very basics and EDC is also basic subject. But coming to this control systems, you need to have some Laplace transforms information. That means signals and systems should be completed before starting this control systems. And coming to this digital circuits also, in case of digital circuits, whenever you are reading about the ADC and DAC, analog to digital circuits and digital to analog circuits, you need to have some network theory basics. So, but even though network theory basics are required for the digital circuits and Laplace transforms are required for the control systems, we can combine those two subjects into the basic subjects only, because remaining all topics are easy only. So you can able to start your preparation along with mathematics and general aptitude. You can able to read this network theory and signals and systems and EDC also. And after completion of those three, you can able to start control systems and digital circuits. Like this, you can able to plan your preparation. Next, coming to this core subjects. Actually, in the core subjects, we have three subjects like communication systems, analog circuits and electromagnetic fields and transmission lines. In case of analog circuits, without knowing about EDC, that means electronic devices and circuits knowledge, and without knowing the network theory, we cannot able to study the analog circuits. So you need to have the knowledge of network theory and electronic devices and circuits in order to understand the analog circuits. So we can broadly divide these subjects into the subjects which are not required any prerequisite and the subjects which requires the prerequisite. Prerequisite is nothing but one subject is required in order to understand the another subject. For example, just now I have told about the analog circuits. In order to understand the analog circuits, you require the knowledge of the other subjects like network theory and EDC. Without understanding those two, you cannot able to understand this analog circuits. And coming to communication systems, this is also under the group 3 only. And communication systems requires the knowledge of the Fourier transform. Purely Fourier transform is required in order to understand the analog communication or digital communication. So that after studying these signals and systems, then only you can able to start the communication subject. That's why we can able to put this communication subject in the group 3. And coming to last one, that is electromagnetic fields and transmission lines. In case of electromagnetic fields and transmission lines, we need to have the knowledge of the vector calculus. Without having the knowledge on the vector calculus, we cannot able to understand the electromagnetic fields and transmission lines from starting onwards. So in order to have command on the tough subject, this is one of the tough subjects we can able to say in our gate preparation for the EC people. So some people can able to leave this particular electromagnetic fields and transmission lines without spending much time on that one. Remaining subjects we can able to read. Otherwise, if you want to master on that subject, imagination power is required. Okay, without imagining, you cannot able to understand the electromagnetic fields and transmission lines. This is about the syllabus includes in the GATE examination for the EC people. Next, how to prepare for the GATE examination, that I am going to discuss now. In case of the GATE examination, now we have divided the subjects into three groups. Already that part is over. So you need to listen the classes properly. After listening, you need to write down the notes. In two ways you can able to make the notes. One is main notes, second one is the short notes. In case of the main notes, you need to write each and every point in detail. Okay, while listening the class itself, you can able to make a note of that one. And each and every point you need to include in the main notes. And in case of the short notes, all the formula you can able to write, and what points are important for you, you can able to write in that particular short notes. Some people requires more number of statements. Some people requires less number of statements. That means already they may familiar with that particular concepts. So they no need to write in the short notes because already they know about that one. And some people requires to write that point in their notebook. That means it is related to person to person. So every person has to prepare their own short notes. Then it is easy to revise while examination is going on, or whenever you are going to write any competitive examination, including GATE, you can able to revise by using that particular short notes without wasting much time. So this is after making that notes, then you need to prepare the previous GATE examination questions, including IAS exams also. And for example, if you consider the EDC subject, the subject is available for EC people, and some other branches also are having that particular subject. So you can able to solve the previous questions of other branches also. Then you will get more perfection and you will get more confidence on that particular subject. So like this, you can able to write the online exams also in order to have the confidence on your particular subject, or in your weaker section areas of that particular section, you can able to build up the confidence. So in this way, your preparation has to be done. And in the GATE examination, totally 65 questions will be there. And out of 65, 30 questions are 1 mark questions and 35 questions are 2 marks questions. So in case of 2 marks questions and in case of 1 marks questions also, you can able to have all the concepts, all the questions from the all the subjects. And particularly, the question types will be MCQ, MSQ and NET. Like this, different questions are there. Multiple choice questions means we know about that one. Question will be given and 4 options will be given. Out of 4 options, only 1 option will be correct. And in case of the MSQ, multiple select questions, out of 4 options, more than 1 option is correct. Okay, you need to make that one very clearly about the MSQ questions. Next, coming to NET, your fill in the blanks will be given. So you need to fill that particular blank with the correct option. So here options will not be given. You need to write the answer in that particular blank. So in this way, the questions will be available in the GATE examination. So like this, you need to prepare in order to crack the GATE examination. Then you can able to score good marks in the GATE examination. By securing good rank in the GATE examination, we can able to go for the higher studies in the IITs or the NITs, and we can able to get the job in the PSUs also. And the PSU jobs are very good jobs, and we can able to get a good amount of salary also in case of the PSU. And in order to get the job in the PSUs through the GATE examination, we need to secure a good rank that is below 500. And getting the rank below 500 is not that much amount of difficult also. And already we know that 30 marks are allocated for the general aptitude and mathematics. And by studying some easy subjects like network theory, signal sense systems, control systems and digital circuits, it is easy to achieve that much amount of rank. So we can able to get the job through the PSUs also by using this particular GATE examination. And most of the people are getting the M.Tech seats in the IITs by using this GATE examination also. If you consider the previous GATE examination called GATE exam, if you consider the previous GATE examination, that is GATE 2022, by having the marks in GATE examination, that is 50 to 52, the people got the rank below 500. And by securing the marks about 60, they got the ranks below 150, so that easily they can able to get the jobs in the PSU. And previously, the people got the 85 marks also. For out of 100, they got 85 marks also in the EC branch out of 1 lakh people. So it is not that much difficult to get the good marks in the GATE examination. With proper preparation strategy, we can able to achieve this one. We have to spend more amount of time for the GATE preparation. So if you prepare for 2 hours per daily or 3 hours per daily, it is not possible to get the good rank. So we need to spend a lot of time per day. అరౌండ్ 8 to 10 hours వీ హ్యావ్ టు స్పెండ్ పర్ డే, దెన్ ఓన్లీ ఇట్ ఈస్ పాసిబుల్ టు గెట్ ది గుడ్ అమౌంట్ ఆఫ్ ర్యాంక్ ఇన్ ది గేట్ ఎగ్జామినేషన్. యూ నీడ్ టు అలకేట్ అరౌండ్ 6 to 8 months ఫర్ ద గేట్ ప్రిపరేషన్. ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ ద కోచింగ్ ఇట్ సెల్ఫ్ ఈస్ టేకింగ్ ది 6 months, మీన్స్ యూ నీడ్ టు స్పెండ్ ఆన్ రీజన్ పర్పస్ ఓన్లీ యూ నీడ్ టు స్పెండ్ ది 2 months అమౌంట్ ఆఫ్ టైం. సో మల్టిపుల్ టైమ్స్ యూ హ్యావ్ టు రివైజ్ ద వీకర్ సెక్షన్స్ ఆఫ్ యువర్ సబ్జెక్ట్. బై రైటింగ్ ది ఆన్లైన్ టెస్ట్ సిరీస్ ఎగ్జామినేషన్స్ యూ కెన్ ఏబుల్ టు నో ఇన్ విచ్ ఏరియా ఆఫ్ ద సబ్జెక్ట్ యూ ఆర్ ఇన్ ది వీక్ స్టేజ్, సో దట్ యూ కెన్ ఏబుల్ టు అండర్స్టాండ్ యువర్ వీకర్ పోర్షన్ ఆఫ్ ద సబ్జెక్ట్ అండ్ యూ కెన్ ఏబుల్ టు కాన్సన్ట్రేట్ ఆన్ దట్ పర్టికులర్ పోర్షన్ ఆఫ్ దట్ పర్టికులర్ సబ్జెక్ట్. దెన్ యూ కెన్ ఏబుల్ టు సెక్యూర్ గుడ్ అమౌంట్ ఆఫ్ మార్క్స్ ఇన్ దట్ పర్టికులర్ సబ్జెక్ట్ ఆల్సో. సో ఓవరాల్లీ యూ కెన్ ఏబుల్ టు రైట్ ది గేట్ ఎగ్జామినేషన్ వెల్. ద బెస్ట్ ఇన్స్టిట్యూట్ ఫర్ ది ఆన్లైన్ కోచింగ్ సెంటర్ ఫర్ ది గేట్ ఎగ్జామినేషన్ ఈస్ ద ట్యూటిట్యూట్ ఇన్స్టిట్యూట్. ఇన్ ది ట్యూటిట్యూట్ ఇన్స్టిట్యూట్ ద ఫ్యాకల్టీ మెంబర్స్ ఆర్ ఫ్రమ్ ది ఎన్ఐటీస్ అండ్ ఐఐటీస్ అండ్ దే ఆర్ వర్కింగ్ ఇన్ ది పిఎస్యూస్ ఆల్సో. దే ఆర్ మోర్ ఎక్స్పీరియన్స్డ్ పీపుల్ అండ్ దే కెన్ ఏబుల్ టు టీచ్ వెల్. యూ కెన్ ఏబుల్ టు ప్రిఫర్ ది ట్యూటిట్యూట్ ఇన్స్టిట్యూట్ ఫర్ యువర్ గేట్ ఎగ్జామినేషన్. ఆల్ ది బెస్ట్. థ్యాంక్ యూ సో మచ్.